Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss about the topic relation. Relation is the first topic of class 12th. Relation algebra, when we go in the history of the relation, then we come to know that De Morgan and Charles Peirce are known as the father of the relation, because the relation algebra was developed in the 19th century by De Morgan and Charles Peirce. The equational form of relation algebra was developed by Alfred Tarski and his students in the year 1940. Tarski and Gibbent in the year 1987 applied relation algebra to a variable-free treatment of axiomatic set theory, with the implication that mathematics founded on set theory could itself be conducted without variable. Now coming to the topic relation. So before the relation, we must know about the Cartesian product that we have studied earlier. Cartesian product, let there are two non-empty sets A and B. Here I have taken A as 1, 2, 3 and B equal to 2, 3. These are two non-empty sets. Then Cartesian product A cross B is given by set of ordered pairs in which first element is from set A and second from set B. That is 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 3, 3. Here we see that number of elements in A are 3 and number of elements in B are 2. Then number of elements in A cross B are 6. And if we form the total subsets of this Cartesian product A cross B that contains 6 elements, then total number of subsets will be 2 to the power 6, that is 64. If we write the subsets, they will be, first subset will be 5, then 1, 2, 1, 3, like this. Then we will take 2 elements together, then taking 3 elements together, then 4 elements, and so on. And finally, A cross B, that is set itself. Each subset is a relation. This is the definition of relation. What relation is? It is the subset of Cartesian product A cross B. Here we see phi, that phi is known as an empty relation or null relation. A cross B set itself, it is known as universal relation. Now coming to the types of relations. Types of relations I will explain by taking two examples of each type. First, example number one, let a relation from natural numbers to natural number given by r equal to xy such that x equal to y. If we write the relation, it will be 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 and so on. Second example, suppose a relation in a set of all triangles and the relation is given by xy such that x is similar to y. So we see that when triangles are similar, then each triangle is similar to itself. So every element in both the examples is related to itself. Such a relation is known as reflexive relation when AA belongs to R for every element of the set. Then coming to the next relation, suppose R equal to XY such that X plus Y equal to 6 and the relation is again from N to N. R is given by 1, 5, 5, 1, because we will write those ordered pairs whose sum is 6 and both the numbers are from natural numbers. So it is 1, 5, 5, 1, 3, 3, 4, 2, 2, 4. Another example, a relation in the set of all lines in a plane be given by R equal to XY such that X is perpendicular to Y. In this relation, we see that whenever a line L1 is perpendicular to L2, then L2 is also perpendicular to L1. So in both the examples, we see that whenever first element is related to second, then second element is also related to first. Such a relation is said to be symmetric. Whenever AB belongs to R, then BA also belongs to R. Now coming to the next, that is, whenever relation A to A, where A is 1, 2, 3, we let us take R equal to XY such that x is less than y. So r will be 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3. In this we will write those ordered pairs which satisfy the condition that first element is less than second element. So we see that whenever A is less than B, B is less than C, then A is less than C. Second example, suppose a relation in the set of all lines in a plane be given by R equal to XY such that X is parallel to Y. Here we see that whenever L1 is parallel to L2, L2 is parallel to L3, then L1 is parallel to L3. Such a relation is said to be transitive. Whenever AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R, then AC belongs to R. It means whenever A is related to B, B is related to C, then A is related to C. Such a relation is said to be transitive. Now, a relation which is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive is known as an equivalence relation. So I am taking again an example to explain the equivalence relation. Suppose a relation from A to A, where set A is 1, 2, 3, is given by R equal to XY such that X plus Y less than equal to 6. In this, we will write those ordered pairs which satisfy this condition that their sum is less than or equal to 6. So when we write the ordered pairs, we see that it contains all the ordered pairs that comes in A cross A. That is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. Here we see that every element is related to itself. 1 related 1, 2 related 2, 3 related 3. Also we observe that whenever A is related to B, B is also related to A. For example, 1 is related to 2, then 2 is also related to 1. Similarly, whenever A is related to B, B related C, then A related C. We can see that 1 related 3, 3 related 2, then 1 related 2. So this relation is an equivalence relation. Another example, suppose a relation R in the set Z of integers defined as R equal to XY such that X minus Y is integer is an equivalence relation. We see X, X belongs to R. Because X minus X gives you 0, that is an integer. So R is reflexive, every element is related to itself. Suppose XY belongs to R, it means X minus Y is integer. We know whenever X minus Y is integer, then Y minus X is also integer. So YX also belongs to R, this relation is symmetric. Suppose XY belongs to R, it means X minus Y is integer. Y z belongs to R, it means y minus z is integer. As we know, whenever we add two integers, we again get an integer. So adding x minus y and y minus z, it gives x minus y plus y minus z is also integer, which implies that x minus z is integers. So xz belongs to R, it means it is transitive. So this is another example of equivalence relation. Now a few more examples I am giving you one by one. First, a few examples of reflexive relation like is equal to. Is a subset of, in the case of set, divides. Whenever A divides B, it means every element divides itself. Is greater than or equal to. Is less than or equal to. These all are examples of reflexive relation. Now a few examples of symmetric relations. Is equal to. Is married to. In most legal systems, whenever A is married to B, it means B is also married to A. Is a fully biological sibling of. Is a homophone of. In English, when we see that a word is homophone of other, then other word is also homophone of first. Is co-worker of. Is teammate of. These all are examples of symmetric relations. Few examples of transitive relations. Is an ancestor of. Is greater than. Is a subset of. Whenever A is subset of B, B is subset of C, then A is subset of C. Divides. Whenever A divides B, B divides C, it means A divides C. So these are few examples of transitive relations. Thank you.